Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I'm doing a little catch-up video. A lot of you have had the same questions, and we haven't had a face-to-face in a while, so why not? First of all, I want to tell you thank you for all your prayers and good wishes for my little neighbor boy, Colson. Well, I guess he's not so little, he just turned 19 in October. As far as we know, there's no more cancer in his system. However, tomorrow he is having his last big surgery, and it's going to be about 9 hours. They discovered that the very large tumor in his abdomen wasn't cancerous. It was benign. And that's the good news. The bad news was that it didn't respond to the chemo because of that. So it kept growing and growing. And so tomorrow he has to have that tumor out, and he's probably going to lose his kidney as well. Which isn't good, but you can certainly live a long, healthy life with only one kidney. So we're hoping this is it, and he should have a clean bill of health after that. He'll be in ICU for a while, but the worst should be definitely behind him. So if you're inclined, please say a little prayer for Colson tomorrow and have him in your thoughts. And thank you so much for all your prayers previously that brought him to this point. And also, some of you may know Jim down in Texas. He's a regular in our Homestead Honey Hour chat room, and he's just a quirky, wonderful, funny little guy we all enjoy and love at the Homestead Honey Hour. Well, he had heart surgery on Monday, and so he's going to be laid up for a while. So if you're inclined as well, please think of Jim down in Texas and send a prayer up for him too. We're thinking about you, buddy. Okay, my vinegar experiment. A lot of you have asked for an update on that. I really don't know how it's coming. Of the three jars, I have one that's red, like apple cider vinegar, and two that are still kind of white, like regular vinegar. They're still drawing fruit flies. I need to get them out in the garage. And I can't decide whether they smell like vinegar or not. So I'm going to give it longer, and I will do an update video, but I'm still just kind of letting it be, and before I decide yay or nay. I would probably use Mrs. Wolfie Bev's method that she demonstrated on her channel. So go over there. I think that's a better way, and I'm going to do that next time rather than just the cores and the water thing, because I'm not convinced that it works. One of my videos I put up recently, I showed how I used my jelly that didn't set, and I made a chili sauce. And I combined it with some homemade chili sauce. And a lot of people said, oh, will you do a video on making chili sauce, or what's your recipe? And I can't do a video right now on it because there's no tomatoes in Michigan that are ripe. It's wrong season. That's number one. Number two, I don't have a special chili sauce recipe. I just use what's in the Ball Blue Book, and I think it's on page 55. That's my chili sauce recipe. It's nothing special, guys. So I don't know if I'll even do one next year when we have tomatoes, because it's not like some cherished family recipe that I think is really good that I'm going to share with you. It's just what's in the Blue Book. A lot of you have asked about the baby goats that we had this summer, Bree and Bob. Bree, we think, had a problem, but we aren't sure. She went to a lovely home. I placed her in a home. They are well aware of her situation, and they are willing to give her the benefit of the doubt. They're going to try to breed her next fall. They didn't want to breed her this year. And hopefully she'll take, and she will be a wonderful, productive doe for them. That's what I'm hoping anyway. And Bob got placed with a lovely family. My hay guy has a little boy named Simon, and he's just adorable. And he's getting into 4-H, and he wanted a goat. So I asked him if he'd want Bob, and he did. So he and Bob are a team. He leads him all over, takes him all over, and he's going to use him in 4-H next year. So no, we didn't have to eat Bob. One of these days we're going to have a boy goat, and I'm going to have to eat him. But so far, my husband's putting the girls to bed, yeah. Rosebud, the little piglet that we had, she went to a good home. They're going to use her as a breeder, so I'm hoping good things for them too. As far as baby piglets, some people have asked, are you going to have baby piglets for sale in the future? And I hopefully will have a litter this next spring, but it's going to be early summer, late spring. Probably end of May, first part of June is when I'm planning on a litter of piglets. And if all goes right, yes, I will have weaned piglets for sale probably the end of August, first part of September. They won't be expensive, $50, $100, somewhere in there. Because I don't know if my pigs are purebred Cooney Cooney. I don't think they are. But if you're looking for a smaller homestead hog, a lard type pig that the meat is to die for, they will certainly fit the bill, either as a breeding animal or to eat. So I will have piglets, hopefully. I don't have my fodder system in place yet. I meant to, but where I want to put it in the basement under one of our casement windows, because we just have an unfinished basement, my husband has a bunch of stuff. And he hasn't moved the stuff out of the way so I can set up my bigger fodder system. But hopefully I'll get to that after the holidays. I got to nag some more. My life. Okay, now here's my little mini rant. I hate Google Plus that YouTube is using now. Hate it. I have tried to get used to it. I have tried to educate myself. I went to the, what's it called, YouTube Creator Academy channel. And I started watching videos there on how to use this new Google Plus. And, these were really cool made videos. There was four guys with lovely British accent. They're all got cooking channels. And it was really clever because they were opening up a refrigerator, like a freezer door, and it was like you were in the freezer and they were talking to you and telling you how wonderful Google Plus was and all the tools you're going to have for your channel. And they never explained the bloody thing to you. Anyway, sorry. I was so frustrated. I don't know how many videos I watched, and they never got to the meat and potatoes. They just told you how wonderful it all was and how it was going to impact your channel and be so great. And, well, tell me how to use the thing. So anyway, there's just way too much stuff. And I really feel like YouTube should have given its users a choice of how many whistles and bells we wanted. Maybe do three tiers of whistles and bells. You know, if you want it the way it is, great, but here's this package. Or here's the full-blown, all the little tools you could ever want package. And let us choose, but they didn't. So I don't know where half the stuff is. I don't know how it all works. I want to tell you right now, I don't know what circles are. I don't know what they're for. And please don't be offended if I don't join your circle or I don't invite you to a circle, because I'm not doing the circles thing. I don't know what it is. And I don't have time, you know? And same with the communities. I feel so bad. I've gotten a couple invites to communities, and I'm really flattered that you would invite me. But again, I don't know what they are. I don't know what it's for. And frankly, I don't have a lot of time these days. That's why I don't put up as many videos as I used to. With working full time and the farm and homeschooling now, I just don't have the time. And I tend to. So if circles and communities are going to be more internet time, I just can't do it. I don't Twitter and tweet and Facebook and all that social media stuff. I just don't do it. And in fact, I hate Facebook. And YouTube is starting to remind me of Facebook a lot. I think it's trying to be Facebook. And if I wanted to be on Facebook, I'd be on Facebook. But YouTube's the only thing I do. And I'm just really left behind with all these changes. I'm trying to keep up, but over my head. I keep thinking of a quote from one of my favorite movies. It's The Prize Winner of Defiance, Ohio. If you haven't seen that movie, you need to get that movie because it's a wonderful movie. And unfortunately, the main character is talking to her husband when she says this, but it applies so well to this situation. If I could talk to YouTube, I would say, I don't need you to make me happy. I need you to leave me alone when I am. Anyway. So, just don't be offended if I don't join in all these extra things that Google Plus is now offering, because I just don't understand them, and I don't really have the time. So it's nothing personal. Okay, upcoming videos. I'm gonna get to it. We have all the stuff. Making the little Christmas drums ornaments from pool noodles, and that's my next one. Hopefully this week or the weekend. The girls are both having sleepovers here so this weekend, so maybe by Sunday afternoon. I'm also going to be doing some Christmas giveaways, probably books. I wasn't going to be doing any more book giveaways. I won't go into why, but I thought that had pretty much run its course on my channel, but it's Christmas and I kind of miss them, so I'll be doing some more giveaways. I'm going to also be doing another one pot go-to meal that I make quite a bit that I think might help some of you out there as that are busy as well. And, you know, nothing gourmet. Everything I make is pretty darn simple and straightforward. So if you're looking for the exotic stuff, as far as cooking, not my channel. But if you're looking for fast and easy and simple, then tune in for that. I also have a ton of pig fat in my freezer that I have to at some point render into lard. So I'll be doing that as a first timer. And hopefully it's not one of my learn from my mistakes videos, which I'm kind of famous for. Hopefully I have success. I'm studying up on it right now. I'm also going to be making some quail cages over the winter because I want to get quail in the spring. And I'll show you those or take you along for that. And what else? Oh, the one thing I didn't get to that I really hope to this fall was hooping over my front beds for a high tunnel or an unheated greenhouse. And the ground's frozen. We have about 2-3 inches of snow right now. It's very pretty. Kids are sledding. It's great. But that means we won't be pounding in T-posts and that to hoop over the beds. I want to use stop panels. I have the plastic. I have the stop panels. It's just we ran out of time. So hopefully in the early spring, I will get someone to help me. And then another video I'm going to be doing, and this is going to be a girls only video, is about concealed carry for women and an option you may not be aware of or haven't heard of, and I'll be talking about that. So those are things I have planned, probably some other ones here and there. I know everybody likes to see the animals, but they don't change that much, or hopefully they don't change that much. So I don't do necessarily animal videos just to say, hey, they're still here. I know the kids that follow my channel like that, but I don't want to bore everybody. So anyway, I just wanted to do a little face-to-face. I want to thank you so much for your prayers for Colson. They worked. We knew they would. And just to give you answer some questions that I've been receiving from numerous people. So, oh, one thing about correspondence. I just emptied out my inbox of 800 emails and whatnot. I will get to you. The problem when I get a letter from somebody I know is I want to sit down and I want to write a good long letter. And then I think, well, I don't have time right now. I'll get to it later. Well, I'm coming to a conclusion. I just have to sit down and do it. I'm never going to have time. And some of you have been very patient waiting. Diana, I owe you a note, a letter. I know. And I will get to it. That's always been my Achilles heel, is answering private messages or questions, private messages in a timely manner. I always try to do better, but the problem is as my channel gets bigger, I get more of them. So it's a vicious circle. I'm still trying to do better. So please bear with me and know there's just one of me and many of you, and I'll do the best I can with them. So anyway, thank you guys for tuning in and staying with me, and all the wonderful comments that you leave on my videos. Welcome and thank you to all my new subscribers. I hope you find this channel worth your time. And I'm looking forward to the holiday season. I hope you have a great Thanksgiving. And I'll be back. Bye-bye.